Hello everyone, hope you're having a great day and welcome to this little example problem video I wanted to make. Should be quick and dirty and easy, but I just wanted to make this as a little refresher to make sure we understood the last chapter. This brings in all the different concepts of mitosis and meiosis. If you can calculate the number of chromosomes and the number of DNA molecules at any stage of the cell cycle, whether it's mitosis or meiosis, you're off to a really good start. So in this, apologies, dog just left the room. Didn't want to hear this, apparently. Fine. Be that way, Watson. This is exciting. What are you talking about? All right. Anyway, in this little example problem here, what we're going to do is look at, and you know, I think we're using mice as the example of how many chromosomes. Remember, what defines a chromosome? A chromosome can be defined as one single, you know, chromosome unit. Then remember, it replicates itself and forms a sister chromatid. So this is, you know, called, you know, a chromosome as well. So this is one chromosome and this is one chromosome. Then remember, these sister chromatids separate in anaphase of mitosis. When they separate, then little chromosomes here, now this is two chromosomes. So it all depends, you know, a lot of people screw up chromosome number because this is one, not two, but then once they separate, it's two. So we'll use this as an example problem going through this. And then we'll also look at meiosis as well, and how many chromosomes versus DNA molecules are in each. So here, talking about DNA molecules, then this would be one DNA molecule. This would be two DNA molecules. And then this would still be two DNA molecules. So we're going to go through this example and see if we can figure it out. And now I recommend pausing at this point, trying to work through this on your own. See if you can work through this and fill it all in, and then check your answers with me going over it. So draw yourself a little table here. The example we're using here is a mouse. So in a mouse, 2n is equal to 20. Remember, 20 is the diploid number. And for future, when we're looking at meiosis, remember, the haploid number is equal to 10. So then this is haploid. Again, this is a nice little summary of the last chapter. So the question here is, how many chromosome and DNA molecules are at G1, G2, all stages of mitosis, and metaphase 1, 2, and cytokinesis of meiosis? I know it's a, you know, a heavy worded question, but it's pretty much fill in this table. How many? What's the chromosome number and what's the DNA molecules? And again, this is a great time to pause it and then work through this yourself. And then when I work through it, you figure out, oh, how was I thinking during that and so forth. But I'm going to get into it now. So no spoilers. All right. So we're at G1 of the cell cycle. Remember the cell cycle? We go from after cytokinesis, we enter G1, which is the normal active state where the cell's growing and being active. And then it could enter G0, which is the undividing state. And then it enters S phase. So between G1 and G2, we have S phase where we go through DNA synthesis and replication. So knowing that G1, the cell is at its normal state, its diploid state. So the number of chromosomes here is 20. The number of DNA molecules here is also 20. We didn't go through DNA replication yet. Then between G1 and G2, we go through DNA replication. So that's when we go from this to this. Remember what I just talked about on the welcome slide. This is still 20 chromosomes. However, we formed another DNA molecule. So now we're up to 40 DNA molecules. And then we enter mitosis. So all of these next, this next section here is all mitosis. So let's think about mitosis now. Prophase, remember, is where we're condensing the DNA and it's getting ready to go through the rest of mitosis here. So prophase, we still have 20 chromosomes and we have 40 DNA molecules. Metaphase, remember, we're lining up at the middle. And here we still have 20 chromosomes and 40 DNA molecules. Now, anaphase is where it gets interesting because anaphase is where these two chromosomes over here separate. So now momentarily, since this is all still contained within the same cell, the number of chromosomes actually jumps to 40. The DNA molecules remains at 40. Now, cytokinesis, we get a separation and two new cells forming, each of them with 20 chromosomes in them. And then we also get a separation of DNA molecules, so we're back to 20 here as well. And then we start everything back over. So this is, you know, normal mitosis. This is what your cells are mostly going through. Now, let's look at meiosis over here. Remember, meiosis forms your germ cells, like sperm and eggs. And now you have to have a haploid amount, where N is equal 10, of chromosomes. So you remember, you go from a diploid cell of 20 to a haploid cell of 10, because that when fertilization occurs, you're adding those two 10s together to make 20 again. So let's think about chromosome numbers and DNA molecules in this example. Remember, meiosis is broken up into meiosis 1 and meiosis 2. And again, just to do a little brief summary here, you start with that 2N cell, you go through meiosis 1, and then you already are at a diploid cell. And then you divide, so two diploid cells here, and then you divide those again in meiosis 2, again, forming two diploid cells from each, so you end up forming four daughter cells. So metaphase one, this is during this stage here. So metaphase one, if we're drawing one example here, remember you have homologous pairs that are lined up at the middle. So here you would still have, let me draw another one right there. So one for each, you'd still have 20 at this point, but you'd have 40 DNA molecules. So similar step here for replicating the DNA on each size. And then here, you then separate the homologous pairs. Oops. So you're separating the homologous pairs here. So still, when we get through the end of this, so if we were to think, what would anaphase be here? Look, we have two homologous pairs separating. We're not separating the sister chromatids. So we don't actually change the chromosomes number. So anaphase one would still be 20 as well. Then you separate these into two new cells, and that's how you get 10. So after the first round of cytokinesis, so if we're looking at cytokinesis meiosis one here, going into this stage, we then have 10 chromosomes in each cell. I hope that makes sense there, because I know I didn't include the different tables for it, but imagine these, you know, anaphase, you're separating these each side, and then you make two new cells from each of these. So you'd cut that chromosome number in half, so we'd be at 10. So that's how you get from 2N to N right there. So again, I didn't include it in the table here because it wasn't part of this example problem, but the cytokinesis end of meiosis one would have 10 chromosomes. Now let's look at metaphase two. So then this one then goes through meiosis two, so going through prophase, where it doesn't really condense the DNA again, usually just stays in that state. And then we're lining up in the middle in metaphase two, where we should have 10. Remember, at this point, this is where, you know, if I'm only drawing one of these chromosomes from over here now, we're now going to be separating sister chromatids. So now when, oops, let's go back. Now when we go back here, we're separating these. So remember, the cohesins break here, and pulling them to each side. When they separate at anaphase two, we actually, because this chromosome separates, jump back up to 20. Then at the end of cytokinesis, then does then separate, we form different cells from each of these. We then are back at 10 from separating those into two different cells. And then for the DNA molecules down here, and I kind of forgot to talk about these ones during these steps. So for DNA molecules, so we have 40 here, and then we're going to end up with double here. So we'd be back down to 20 because we're separating each side here. So these ones would cut in half here, and then also they would then cut in half again here. So then we'd be down to 10 chromosomes and 10 molecules of DNA then. Then when fertilization occurs, let's say fertilization then occurred in this cell, you'd be combining these ones with another cell, and then you'd be back to 20. So I hope that all made sense there. Feel free to comment or, you know, ask me questions about any different stages, any different steps in this. Again, this is one example problem. Imagine doing this with any other example problem. This is just a simple, you know, 20 and 2N and so forth. You could do this with humans and whatever. But yeah, let me know if you have any questions. I hope this helped, you know, see if you, how well you understood mitosis versus meiosis. and how many chromosomes you find. Again, the big thing is in understanding what the definition of a chromosome is, what the definition of a sister chromatid is, homologous pairs, and so forth. But that's all I have for this little example today. Again, hope it summarized everything well, and I'll see you all next time. Bye-bye.